It's yours. Jurassic Park. It's your job to make it work. Just build the park and populate it with dinosaurs. Lots of dinosaurs. This will be the greatest theme park in the history of the world. Your job is to keep the park gates open. Prove to InGen that the park is viable and safe.
Code Red, this is Park Control. Raptor breakout in Sector 32. Code Red. Copy that, Control. I'm reading 6 visitors in Sector 32.
You have a T-Rex.
Don't forget, she's a hunter. Design it, build it, breed dinosaurs. It's yours, Jurassic Park.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and welcome to Jurassic Park Operation Genesis. Yes, it's time for Season 9 or something. Bit of a nostalgia trip, bit of a trip down memory lane for a lot of us here. And not only do I really want to play some JPOG, because, you know, Evolution 2's on the way, it's good to remember where we came from, basically. But 5 days ago, as you may have seen on my Twitter lately, was actually the 10-year anniversary of my channel since the day I very first uploaded a video. That was on the 15th of September 2011. So this is my 10-year birthday, basically, as a YouTuber. And for me, there were a lot of games that helped me get here, a lot of things that helped me get here, but JPOG was the one. It was that game that really turned things from random YouTubing into my niche and into a new area that I could, you know, establish myself and kind of help create and stuff like that when YouTube was burgeoning. And JPOG is just that game that really solidified what I was going to be as a channel and who I was going to be as a content creator. So I owe everything to this game in a lot of ways and a few others which we'll talk about throughout this series. And I really wanted to celebrate that, and I know a lot of you missed the playthrough, because why wouldn't you? It's JPOG, it's been a few years now, we used to do it every year, but it's taken a back seat lately. And let's get started.
Hello, my name is John Hammond, and I am in charge of InGen, the company that you now work for. Your job is quite simple, really. Build a park, create dinosaurs, and entertain people. Of course, we'll be keeping an eye on you as well. We'll watch your park rating and give you feedback on your performance. But in the end, the success or failure of Jurassic Park is all up to you.
Have to let Hammond do his thing. Quite like that one. Let's get started. JPOG, guys. JPOG. Poggers, as they say. I'm down with the kids. Right, so before we get started, I want to talk about a few things. I will be saving regularly throughout this playthrough. I have tried to make this video 3 times now, and the game does keep crashing. It's an old game, and I've modded the bejeebus out of it. Actually, I haven't. We'll talk about that next. But I'm going to be saving fairly regularly, so at least if it does crash, I can come back in rather than losing 20, 30 minutes of progression every single bloody time. In terms of mods, what have I done? I really wanted this to be a nostalgia trip. You know, we're going to be talking a lot about the history of the channel, kind of reminiscing on good old JPOG back in the day, etc. So I wanted to keep this as close as possible to how I would do those old playthroughs. That means we're playing with DJE, which is what's giving it the really nice graphical effect, and what will also affect the look of our dinosaurs as well. I'm using the Forgotten just for a path mod, and that's it. And that is literally it. No new dinosaurs or anything like that. This is meant to be as close to the OG, get it? Operation Genesis original, as close to the OG experience as I can stomach, basically. Beyond that, I've made a few more changes by editing the .ini files. I've changed like limits on things like, you can usually only have 60 dinosaurs, for example, and obviously that's nonsense, so we got rid of that. Path limits, fence limits, just number limits, that kind of limitations of the era. And I've also doubled the starting money on one of my two so far. This is the third attempts to record this video. I realized with 60,000 starting money, you run out in about 2 minutes and then you just stare at a screen doing absolutely nothing. It is nowhere near enough cash to really play this game. So I've upped that to 120k, and honestly, even that is not that much. So won't make a big difference in the long term, so just keep us a little bit busier in the early stages of the game. That's it. That's all we've changed. Let's get started. So let's check in with our scientists and advisors and humans. Welcome to your new park. The first thing you'll need to do is hatch some dinosaurs. We'll do that in just a second. We have a dig site. Where have we got? We have Judith River Group A. Lovely dig site, I think you'll all agree. Another thing I've done is, as you can see, unlocked every single dig site. By default, you're limited to 4, I want to say, and you only get those at 5 stars. But what we'll do is what we usually do, in that we don't unlock the next dig site, as in we're going to stick to River Group A until we've maxed out the dinosaurs from A. So we're not going to like hop forward loads and loads or make a big difference. Anyway, yeah, cool. Recent research. Now, if I remember correctly, and it has been a few years, the first thing we always do is grab a medium security fence, just in case we have a big spooky carnivore in our Judith River group. I think it might be Albertosaurus, which is very exciting. And if it is, then we'll have the medium security fence ready to go. And then we just look at vaccines. Nothing but vaccines. JPOG is very time appropriate, just as it always has been. Vaccines have become immensely important in JPOG, so we'll be looking at that next. But we do actually need to open up Lemon Park. So, park entrance. We're going to build right here, down by the coast, which is where we used to always build, you know, in the old builds, and all about the nostalgia today. And then you just start off, nice little line to kick things off. Lovely stuff. Maybe a little bit bigger. Using that blessed old button, P for path, right there. Truly blessed. And we're going to build a fence. And we're going to hope that we have a herbivore. we're going to want an attraction here, aren't we? We're going to want like a viewing vent or something. So what we'll do is put the path along, not the path, we'll put the fence along there, and we'll make the path do a little bit. Or maybe I'll go like this. Go like that instead. We'll go a little bit crazy. I'm a crazy guy, what can I say? There we go, lovely stuff. Demolish that nonsense over there, and we're gonna put a little, maybe I'll put a tower in as well. Instead, actually, I think that's a better idea. Put a tower in there, in the little dink bit there. And dink is an official word, by the way. Then we just need a hatchery, and we get to see what dinosaurs we get. Let's put it there. Alright, are you ready? Our very first dinosaur will be... Hello. Pachycephalosaurus! Very cool. We also have access to... Albertosaurus, it is indeed, right. For those of you who don't know JPOG, you're in for a treat with the Albertosaurus, that's all I'm saying. We're going to start with the Pachycephalosaurus. It's got a higher DNA percentage. Good. We're not going to put out too many of them, though, because we do want... I want 100%. If you've seen me play this game before, you'll know what I'm like. I like my dinosaurs to sit at 100% before I hatch loads of them. Bit more water. Bit of a herbivore feeder as well. Keep that next to the fence so, you know, we can keep the dinosaurs in that area. And I do have quite dense trees because I edited the tree bubble file. I really went, you know, pretty hardcore with the modding this time. Well, with the editing. And you can see trees are usually much further spread than this, but you can make them super dense with a little editing. And there's our first dinosaur! What an absolute beauty. The redhead is a little bit weird, but I do love a redhead, what can I say? But the texture quality and the patterning on the body is phenomenal. It's like really, really good. It's absolutely top notch. It's a beautiful looking dinosaur. And with that Pachycephalosaurus now wandering around, what we can do is open up the park.
How are you today?
You ready? Do 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 bum.
Certainly.
Ladies and gentlemen, wasn't that dramatic? It gives me great pleasure to declare the newest wonder of the modern world, Jurassic Park. Now open.
Thanks, Hammond. He's a good egg. And then we need some basic setup stuff. So what we need is a cleaner station, which, as always, goes here behind the visitor center. We need some amenities, which means a restroom and a kiosk. We'll put that there. Look at that burger. What a top-notch burger that is. And a restroom is going to sit there. Connect those together. Lovely stuff. And the last thing we really need is a ranger station. And I think we're going to do what we always used to do, which is hide it in the mountains. I'm not really sure why this was ever a thing, but I always liked the idea of the helicopter soaring over the mountain tops, you know, to come and save the day. And then we're going to save the game. And I'm afraid you're going to have to get used to this. I don't really have an option.
What would you like us to
Right, so with Ankylosaurus, very exciting.
Yeah.
So Ankylosaurus, Pachycephalosaurus, our armored Judith River group herbivores, they're going to live together. That's going to be really cool. And the next thing we need to do is go to our dig teams. Here we are, fossil hunt. And we're going to buy some teams. And this price goes up exponentially. It gets bigger and bigger over time. So it's 5,000 for this one, then it's 10,000, then it's 20,000. Next one's 40, which is digging into the budget a little bit too much. So we're going to hold back now. And we're just going to plop some of these down like so. And really dig into those dig sites, get ourselves a bunch of fossils. And ladies and gentlemen, that is it. There isn't much else to do in the meantime. Ooh, what are you two doing? Ooh, got a little territorial display here. Get him, get him. I don't know which one I'm talking to. Oh no, my one lost. It's okay, buddy. You'll always be a winner in my eyes, okay? Butterflies. I think Jurassic World Evolution could benefit from stuff like that. You know, butterflies and stuff just floating around. It's cool. They seem to be friends. But you can see this one has the crown symbol. It's established itself as the alpha in the group. Now, we have some messages.
What would you recommend in this situation?
6%! And this will be the fence. Lovely stuff. Let's get started on those vaccines.
Good choice.
Grand, grand, grand. Don't have any guests yet, but they should be on the way moderately soon. Yeah, okay. No guests in the park, and then we just wait, really. So we'll wait till 100% for our dinosaurs to add them. So it does make things a little slower, but it means that quality, hardy dinosaurs. Hardy, hard dinosaurs. You know, it'll be worth it in the end. And now I can talk a little bit about the channel as I save the game. I'm really paranoid about this. So as I say, the channel started 15th of September 2011, but if you go back and look for my first video, you'll see that it actually starts in November of that same year. And that's a Skyrim Part 1. Bloody
Message
Nora.
From Dr. Grant.
What's up, Grant? Oh, more Ankylosaurus. That is a medium, sweet. We want some amber, that's really what we're looking for, a lovely bit of amber. Where are my bloody guests? Come and look at my Pachycephalosauruses. In progress, there we go. Might be able to see the helicopter. Look at that, isn't that beautiful? 20 bloody years old, this game. It's a stunner. It does look fantastic. It always does, especially when you mod it. There it is. Look at that, isn't that awesome? I think it looks great. Especially when it rains, all the lights come on, it looks really dramatic. It's great. Some Pachycephalosaurus, that's cool. Anyways. So I started 15th of September 2011, and the reason I started was, well, basically I was studying my first year at university then, studying biomedical science, and if I'm honest, I didn't love it. I was getting by, but I wasn't in love with the degree. I was just kind of doing it because I thought, well, I should get a degree at some point. So I didn't love the degree. I was in a bit of a weird relationship at the time, and I was just kind of bored. I didn't really have much of a social life in that first year. Let's follow a guest, shall we? Who have we got? Who's come to our park? Lauren, whose first instinct was to go check out the cleaner station. Because Lauren's a mad one. We'll watch Lauren for a little bit as she wanders around. And like I said, kind of the point of this series in part is to go back through the history of the channel. Look at the Pachycephalosaurus in the distance, though. They're huge, aren't they, actually? Oh, I love this heat wave. Look at that sky. That orange effect is beautiful. Lauren loves it! She's having a blast. Alright, anyways. So, I started watching YouTube. And you gotta bear in mind, YouTube was barely a thing back then. I mean, it existed and there were some established channels, but it was very much in its burgeoning state. And I actually started watching Yogscast. And back then, Yogscast was just the two guys. And they were one of the biggest channels in the world. And they used to play mainly Minecraft, but they also played some other games. And I really got into their Dead Island playthrough. Second one with Grant. Oh my god, Amber! Lovely stuff. What quality is it? Is it amazing? It's high! Class. So that's going to give us... Amber basically doesn't tell you what dinosaur it is. So sometimes it's a risk, because it could be a dinosaur you've already got 100% genome. In which case, you've wasted all that money, because look at the value on it. But it will give you tons of DNA, and since we don't have any 100% dinosaurs, it's a guaranteed win. Anyways, I started watching Yogscast, and they had a Dead Island playthrough, as we watched Lauren... Oh, where's she off to? Is she going in the tower? Are we about to go shuka shuka shuka? We are shuka shuka shuka. There she goes. Oh, she's sending... Oh, there she is. It's because she's got a friend. She's got, like, a literal identical twin.
Message from Dr. Grant.
Grant, please, I'm talking to YouTube. My god, this Pachycephalosaurus is going to be a monster. Anyway, they played Dead Island. I thought that looked really fun. I can do that. Yeah, why not? So I started playing Dead Island. Dead Island was the very first game I ever played on the channel. And I did a full playthrough of Dead Island. And then I played Bastion. I played Warhammer 40k Space Marine. I played Fear 3. There might have been another game in there, but I don't quite remember what it was. But I remember those four. And we're talking hundreds of videos. Dead Island was like a 100 episode playthrough or something like that. I'll explain why in a moment.
Message from Dr. Wood.
Actually, well, it's because back then, basically, YouTube... Oh, sweet. Okay, so... Okay, pause on the conversation. Pachycephalosaurus is 100%, so we're going to pop out four more of them. We're going to ramp them up a little bit, get loads of them in there, get our park nice and popular in these early stages. So what we really need now is Ankylosaurus. Please. Let's check out the fossil market. The amber is tempting, but very risky, so this is what I mean. I could spend half my budget, get that amber. That's going to give us tons and tons of DNA, but it could be for the Ankylosaurus, so I'm not going to risk it. For the Pachycephalosaurus, I should say. We're going to buy that.
Good choice.
And we're going to buy that. We've got a bit of spare cash. I think we should spend it. Not too much, though. I need to make sure I can actually afford to set up these the actual exhibits. And let's check in on our fossil hunt. You need to check these, because you see that's mediocre now. That means when that one's done, we're going to pull the teams out of there, because it means we're not getting as high quality fossils from this dig site anymore. So that's poor. So we need to move from there into there. But what did they get? Hey, still got some high Ankylosaurus. That's sweet.
Yes.
Yes. See, he's excited as well. Let's watch someone else. Who's this? Here we go. Chris. He's a good egg, Chris. Chris has a neck beard. Means he's a good lad. You and me. Oh, and he saved it. So paranoid. Alright, 15 minutes. I'm going to try to do it every 20 minutes or so. Every 5 minutes or so. Ooh. Okay, next vaccine is Bumblefoot, I believe. Yes, I'm trying to do the cheaper ones
message
first.
From Dr. Grant.
Dr. Grant, I'm busy! So anyways. I started playing Dead Island, I really enjoyed it, blah blah blah. Back then, YouTube was very different. Like I say, it wasn't really a thing per se. I mean, it was, like I say, there were established channels, but definitely wasn't well known. There wasn't YouTubers, inverted commas, well, not very many of them. For me, as a startup channel with no views, no network or anything like that, I was immensely limited. You know, if any of you started a channel now, you'll know you don't get monetized until you hit a certain number of figures. That's nothing compared to what we went through back in the day. I couldn't upload videos longer than 15 minutes for some reason. 15 minutes was the absolute max. I wasn't allowed to upload thumbnails either. Everything was like an auto-picked thumbnail. You know when someone doesn't upload with a thumbnail and it kind of like takes a screenshot from the video? Don't leave, Chris. Chris, no, you've not seen anything. Oh, there's only one dinosaur, I suppose. Okay, Chris is on his way out. We'll have to pick someone else. Oh, he's changed his mind. He saw these people here. He's like, I'm not going down there. I'm not messing with that lot. What happened to our messages? 69%. Albertosaurus. Right. That said then, whilst I'm talking, I'm going to start setting up an Albertosaurus habitat. Anyways. Who am I talking, please? But yeah, we couldn't do anything. Like, no thumbnails or anything. It was crazy back then. Crazy, folks. Crazy. do I want this? Message oh, I'll make it a big exhibit. Why not? Okay, I've messed up slightly. JPOG's got this slightly annoying, shall we say, grid system that you have to adjust for. I don't know if Albertosaurus even needs a medium, to be honest, but I'd feel bad. Not. Didn't mean to do that. That was completely accidental.
Message from Peter Ludlow.
Oh, I just threw away so much money. Oh, I have no money anymore. So I can't build my fence along that gap there. That has to stay there.
What should we do here?
Oh, we'll get there, folks. We'll get there. 69% is gone, unfortunately. We're still getting a bit of money every time we get a pack of Cephalosaurus fossil. Let's check our quarterly report. I bet he says I'm adequate. I bet he says I'm bloody adequate. Oh, quite satisfied. InGen. Big ol' flirt.
Would it be possible to meet with you at some point?
Cool. It would not be possible to meet with me. We're going to wait a little bit until we've got a bit more cash. I want the Albertosaurus to maybe grow a little bit more. Let's check on this fossil hunt. It's average. We're going to pull out of there. We're going to go full in on the good. Give me that good. Is that Chris? It's Chris. He's still knocking about. This man never leaves. He's getting his money worth. But yeah, YouTube was super limited. And I was getting nowhere. I got like 3-4 views per video. Sometimes in the 20 region, which was like a big deal for me back then. I had this really awkward channel design that was like all lava and rock. Like, YouTube channels used to be hyper customizable. We had backgrounds and banners and color changes and everything. It's like, you know, a website in the mid 2000s, basically. What a bit sort of hold low though, that's a shame. So it used to be hyper customizable. And that was a lot of fun. But really my big break, I was really lucky, it came really early. So you've got to bear in mind back then people were not as technologically savvy, shall we say, as they are these days. So a lot of you may know this, but if a game comes out in, say, New Zealand before it comes out in the West, essentially, in like America or the UK, what you can do is use a VPN, which essentially masks your IP and tells your computer, tells the world that your IP is from another location. You can pretend you're in New Zealand when actually you're in Derbyshire, for example. I'm not in Derbyshire, just to say. But you can pretend that you are. And so when a game comes out earlier in New Zealand, what you can do then is tell Steam that you're in New Zealand and get early access. And whilst I'm sure people did that with Skyrim, not many people did that because it just wasn't a popular tactic back then because people weren't as generally technologically aware. All these bloody lows, I tell you. It's crazy. Come on, Grant. Bring your A game. Oh, yeah, I forgot we've got tons of these guys now. All battling with each other, trying to establish dominance. I actually have so many packs of Cephalosauruses. I didn't realize I had 6. I wonder who actually gets the crown, because there's a lot of them winning. Is it this one here? No. It's this one you just lost, you cheeky blighter. But I played Skyrim, and I played it early. I played as soon as it came out in New Zealand, I was on Skyrim, and that was before the majority of YouTube back then. You know, it's not like it is now where YouTube is this big marketing tool and all the big name YouTubers get games, you know, myself included, for things like Evolution 1 I got earlier, Planet Zoo for example. That just wasn't a thing back then because YouTube wasn't seen as a marketing tool in the way it is now. People didn't value YouTubers in that way that they do now. I'm not saying that's a good thing or a bad thing, I'm not commenting on that. Amber, oh, I really need the cash. Do we risk it? I think I'm going to risk it. If this pack is a Cephalosaurus, this is so annoying. But if it's Albertosaurus, we're ready to go. That'll be awesome. But anyways, it wasn't a big thing. So when I first started playing Skyrim, even though my mic sucked, it was like a built-in headset mic from like a £20 headset, and I couldn't upload longer than 15 minutes, and I had no thumbnails. I was still one of the first on YouTube to ever upload Skyrim, so my videos really took off. And kind of exploded, like, you know, I went from like 5 to 10 views, and there was actually a couple of people out there who were following me even back then. But I went from that to sometimes thousands, or at least hundreds, you know, it was a huge deal for me, and I grew to 3,000 subscribers, like, overnight, basically. The channel just popped off because of the Skyrim playthrough. And I had channel networks getting involved. I signed my first contract with a network who were called, I don't remember, but they were incredibly predatory. Ooh, some silver. This is what we're waiting for. This amber right here. What's it going to be? What is it going to be? I'm nervous. No! $10,000 down the drain. Oh, that's agonizing. Hey, sweet. We got half a star. Thanks, Hammond. What a good egg he is. But anyways, I signed my first contract with the network, and that's what allowed you to get money back then. You couldn't just get monetized, generally speaking. You had to partner with a network who helped you do it. and mine were incredibly predatory. They took 50% of my income. It was literally a 50-50 split, which is what a lot of people will be on initially. I'm on like a 95-5 now, something like that. 90-10. I think 95-5, I can't quite remember. Let's see how many people we get. It used to be, we always used to do this number game where you have to count the amount of money you make and then you have to adjust past there. 4-5! Bloody Nora, we've made £1,000 right there.
Message from Dr. Grant.
Absolutely rolling in it. Come on, lads. I know it's average, but we can do it. I just need a little bit more. Albertosaurus. Oh, the medium won't get me there. It'll be close, but it wouldn't get me there. But anyway, Skyrim kind of gave me my break. I often think if I hadn't made that decision to start playing Skyrim at that time, I may not be here today. Well, I mean, I'd hope I'd be alive, but I wouldn't necessarily be here as a YouTuber, because it really was the game that made my channel, at least initially. And I went hard in on Skyrim for a couple of years. I did a full playthrough, over 200 episodes, all still there on the channel, all with an awful mic. I think it gets better towards the end, but for the start at least, awful mic. And I did a series of Skyrim creation kit tutorials as well, which some of you may have seen. They're like millions of views, super popular. Still the biggest ones out there. Even though, secret, shh, all I did was read the wiki that Bethesda had made for their creation kit, which is like the modding tool for Skyrim. I read it and said it out loud. Put it in my own words and did a video on it, basically. I didn't know a bloody thing. I ended up pretty knowledgeable about Skyrim modding back in the day, but that's a long time ago. I think if I can afford the high Albertosaurus. Oh, a medium, alright. Okay, so what I need to know exactly is how much is a medium worth? A low is worth 5%. Is a medium 10? Because that'll take us to 93% if this is a 10. I guess we'll find out in just a second. But anyway, Skyrim gave me my break. And that went okay for a couple of years. I kind of just kept playing Skyrim, kept playing other games, kind of just trotted along. I was still doing a degree. I was still, especially in second and third year of university, I had much more of a social life, so YouTube often took more of a backseat. I did some webcam videos, I did some horror games. If you want to check out my I Should Not Be a series, might have started back then, or I remember I played a Slenderman game back then with my webcam. Disastrous, terrible quality webcam in a pitch black room with me completely shaven looking like a disaster. But, you know, absolutely, it was fun. I was still doing it for fun at that point. I was making a bit of extra cash. I was making a few hundred quid a month, which for me back then at university was quite a big deal. But it still hadn't properly caught fire. It wasn't a job. I was still intending to go into... actually, the plan at that point was to go to med school. 92%. So we got 9%.
Welcome back.
I'm going to take the risk. I'm a little spooked. We're going to do it. I want that Albertosaurus. What was I saying? Let's follow someone around while we say this. Who are you? Alan! Let's follow... Oh, why is she sad? Oh, I don't care. We'll follow Alan for a little bit. What was I saying? Oh yeah, so that third year of university, 2 years after I started the channel.
Dr. Grant.
So we're talking 2013. Ooh, silver. Nice. I need the cash. Oh, the silver's not worth much. You're looking for gold. Or opals? I think opals are the best. But then I played JPOG. It genuinely was. It was JPOG. You know, JPOG was a game I'd adored as a kid. I played it on the original Xbox. Absolutely loved JPOG. And I just thought, yeah, I'll just play this on the channel. You know, I loved dinosaurs. They weren't as big a part of my life back then, I'll be honest, in any way. I just thought, yeah, I'll play some JPOG, and it just blew up. It really took off, and I thought, maybe this is a thing. So that year is... dinosaur games, in a lot of ways, were taking off as well. You know, Stomping Land was coming out around that time, and other dinosaur games like that. So I started to follow dinosaur gaming as we watch Alan buy some food. What does he want? He's getting a hot dog. There we go. That was very quick service. It doesn't eat it. He doesn't need to eat it. He's just keeping it for later. He's keeping it for the journey home. He's a clever man, is this Alan. Got my Ankylosaurus. I'm really curious what this Alberta is going to end up on. We're praying for 100%. What's up, Alan? He's very confused. Oh, I should save it. I think let's constantly save the game. Anyways. What was I saying? I really don't have a working. Did I hire a cleaner, by the way? I did not. That should have been. That was. Hey, there we go. We finally did it. Right, how much is an Albertosaurus?
Okay.
Sweet. Get two of them. Wait, I can't afford a feeder if I get two of them. Let's get one of them. Just for now, we'll just get one of them. We need a carnivore feeder. We need a little bit of water. And I hope you are ready for the greatest dinosaur noise in the history of video games. It is utterly incredible. How much are these attractions? 1,500. Okay, we'll get that pretty soon. Very exciting to get a new dinosaur, though.
It's good to see.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are happy to announce the newest addition to our park, the fierce and cretaceous carnivore, Albertosaurus. Please enjoy.
There he is. Looks like he's got a bit of feathering going on, texture-wise. There's a little swathe of red under the neck, which I really like. Just waiting for it. Waiting for it to happen.
Message from Dr. Wu.
I'm busy, Wu. I'm busy. I'm looking at my new dinosaur. You see a killer goat. Where's the goat? There's the goat with its lovely
urgent
new texture.
Message from Dr. Wu.
It's not doing it. It's just kind of like acclimating itself, you know, getting ready, getting used to its environment, wandering around, excellent health. In the last 4 whole years, this thing is going to be here for a nice long time. Watch out, goat. Watch out, goat. All right, I'll give him a minute. Check our messages.
You might okay. Want to have a look at this.
Message from Dr. Grant.
Let's go for Dino Belly, and we're going to get ourselves another Albertosaurus.
I'd like your thoughts on this.
Ankylosaurus 65%, Ankylosaurus again. Oh, it's getting a little low though. This might be the time to move on to another dig site. You know, we've got 2 of the 3 dinosaurs. The dig site itself is a little bit higgledy-piggledy at this point. That is the official term, by the way. I think it's time to move on. So we're going to pull out of River Group A. Shut up, no jokes. maybe I'll just stick 2 in there. We'll stick 2 in there for now. And let's go. We're going to do the Eeny, Meeny, Miny, Moe game, as we used to do. So it's Eeny, Meeny, Miny, Moe. Catch a raptor by its toe. If it hollers, let it go. Eeny, Meeny, Miny, Moe. We are going to the Flaming Cliffs. Very cool. And we're going to go that one. Oh, average, though. Ooh, let's go there.
What would you like us to do?
Thank you. They're not doing... Oh, no, it didn't work. The world shook, but the sound didn't come out. That's deeply upsetting. Did it poop? It did. They're saying we are pooping dinosaurs 20 years ago. Where are they in 2021? Nobody knows. Oh, maybe the sound's broken. No, that would be deeply upsetting. Basically, for those who don't know, Albertosaurus has a shriek in this game. A memeable, world-shattering shriek that just... It's the most terrifying thing you've ever heard. It's just a scream, basically. And it's very popular. Someone actually modded it into Jurassic World Evolution. Hopefully they do the same with Evolution 2 as well. Because it's awful, but brilliant. Alright, we need an attraction, I think. Look at that! And what we can do... Change this. I think it's going to be a thrill window, isn't it? Realistically. And you are probably... A playtime platform, although now you can see that one, so maybe not, we'll see. Basically, this is kind of like Jurassic World Evolution 2, in that you can gear your, not your shops, but your attractions to certain types of guests. So you can see that there's ones who want nature, there's ones who want sort of action, there's more sort of general people, stuff like that. Why are you eating, out of curiosity? There's a lot of delicious goats in the area. How are you pooping but not eating? It's a very confusing system you've got going on there, guys. I feel better now the game's saved. Anyways. So, I started playing dinosaur games in that third year-ish. 1 star already, it's just flying up! Right. Anyways, but that's kind of where it took off. JPOG for me is what made me think, huh, maybe I could be a dinosaur gaming channel. Maybe that's a thing that I could basically invent. Now, not to say that other people weren't doing it, that other people hadn't played dinosaur games on YouTube before then, because they absolutely had, but I think I was the first channel to really make it a niche and to lean into it. I'm not trying to big myself up here. I was lucky in that I was just I joined YouTube really early on, you know. I was lucky enough to be there at the foundation of this niche. Whereas now that's a very difficult thing to do because YouTube is so immensely popular.
What should we do about this?
Oh, homocephaly, awesome. YouTube is so immensely popular that it's really hard to find an area that hasn't already been explored. And that's why I think people shouldn't get into it for money anymore, just because it's such a crowded market. If you can find a niche, if you can find something that only you provide, then you've done something very special, because that is just a very difficult thing to do now. But back then it wasn't, so I'm not giving myself tons of credit or anything. I just thought, oh, I'll just play dinosaur games, and inadvertently kind of created a genre to an extent. Or at least popularized it, let's put it that way. Let's check this quarterly report. Well done! Yes, he loves it! He loves my Albertosaurus. He wishes it would scream as well, though. John Hammond loves a screaming Albertosaurus. I can't believe it's not screaming. It's deeply upsetting for me. I'm keeping an eye on when they get super hungry, because I think they do it after a kill. But it's nice that they're hanging out together. I'm glad that they're friends. Or lovers. Don't know, really. Yeah, nice little park.
Hello.
I don't know how long these videos are going to be. I was going to make them all an hour. Maybe I'll do an episode per dig site or something. I don't really have a clue. Alright, so what I meant to do here, by the way. So you just saw that... I was meant to watch this. You need to see how many guests come in. Basically, you need to calculate number of guests against ticket price to maximize the amount of money you can get. Money is really hard to come by in this game, at least early on, so it's actually very important that you maximize your ticket value as much as humanly possible. Come on, Alberti. Scream for me, baby. let's follow a guest for a little bit. Who's this? Carmen. Oh, I have such a crush on a girl called Carmen. Carmen, if you're watching this... No, but I did. She was a very good friend. I had a massive crush on this girl. That was 14 years ago now, though, so... anyways. Yeah, dinosaur games became a thing, and I played lots of other things at the time. Not long before that, fun story, I talked about this on Twitter as well, I actually emailed my partner manager and the network that were taking 50% of my bloody money, and I emailed them to say... I'm gonna quit YouTube. I was just tired. I'd put in hundreds, thousands of hours, and I was still barely getting anywhere. I was scraping by. I was getting really frustrated. So I emailed them and said, "Yeah, I'm quitting. I'm done with YouTube." And they emailed me back saying, "You know, just think about it. Don't feed the dinosaurs, please. Just think about it. But we'll be sad to see you go." Typical stuff. I mean, I wasn't a big channel. They'd have lost like barely any money, so I'm sure they didn't really care. But I sent that email, and then I gave it a few days thought, and I kind of changed my mind. I thought, you know what, I'll just plug on a little bit longer, and we'll see what happens. And not long after that is when I played JPOG, and then the other dinosaur games. I started playing lots of old school dinosaur games, and it kind of all fell into place a little bit. But I was very nearly done. I was very nearly out. It was very nearly... You know, I really wouldn't be here recording today, more than JPOG, more than anything else. That decision to not quit, basically, that few days of thought where I thought, you know what, I'm going to stick around, I'm going to give this a go, it's really the only reason I'm still here doing this now. Let's go check out the market. I want to see if I can get some Anki. Yeah, it's going to cost me a fortune, this, isn't it? Yep, all my money gone. I just want to get this bloody Anki to 100%. I think that's what we'll do. Each video will be getting the dig site to 100% or something like... Ooh, Gallimimus. Very cool. Oh, Lobo. So why am I getting shafted here? What's going on? Let's check out this fossil hunt. This must be pretty bad by now. That's still average. I'm going to pull out there when it's not average anymore. You're average, and we're going to go from... Your average is... Oh, God. I'm going to save the game. But yeah, I quit. I really did. And then in the span of about 6 months, I started playing JPOG, I started playing other dinosaur games, I kind of made it a thing. I was still playing other stuff. I played Castlevania, for example, for some reason, amongst other things. But I started making enough money to make it a job, to make it my living. I wasn't rolling in the cash by any stretch, but I was making a pretty good amount. And university ended. I kind of ummed and ahed about going to med school, but I thought, you know what, YouTube's taking off, this is something we can do, let's go for it. Moved to Manchester, got my own place, and I just kind of went for it, and here we are. Dino Belly. Always had a dino belly. We need more money. See, we're still making a lot of money from that dig site, even though we're not doing anything with it. Oh, did you hear the scream, by the way? I just heard it a second ago. You have a little chow down, buddy. There it is! The scream! The beautiful, bountiful scream. What a stunner. Amazing. So unnecessary, I love it. Yeah, I'd be upset too, pal. Wait, why are you upset though? 100%, 74%. People love it. Everyone else loves it. Who are you, nerd? Come here. I want to berate you, Anna. With your pointy matrix glasses and weird hat. And your tie-dye clothes. Whoa. Whoa, what's going on here?
Message from Dr.
What a bizarre little encounter that was. She's just walking along, walks into her identical twin, her identical, like, with no, you know, introduction or anything. They bump into each other. The identical twin imitates a dinosaur. Anna finds it bloody hilarious and then walks away. That's what just happened. And now she is done. She is out of here. I really need to start doing this. Right, we need to check this time.
I'd like your thoughts on this.
Yeah, in a minute, buddy. In a minute. No, I need to focus. I need to count. In German, remember, eins, zwei, drei, vier, fünf, sechs, sieben. We've got sieben. That means $1,400. So what we're going to do is we're going to up that to 250. And we'll see how many people we get in. And if it's more than 1,400, if it is, we keep it. If it's not, we lower it back down. And if it is, and then we up it to 300 and see if that's higher as well. And we just do this throughout the game to make sure we're maximizing our cash value, basically. Our cash money.
Message from Dr. Grant.
Ankylosaur, eh? That's why I want to say 83% on the Anki. We are getting there, folks. We're on the cusp of greatness. It's this close. I can feel it. We're going to peak. We're going to peak all over everybody. What was I going to do? Oh, research.
Things are good.
I do want to keep getting the vaccines going. Starting to cost a bit. Gastric poisoning, $2,000. Ankylosaurus, yeah. We need another... We've got one medium coming in now. It's a low. I don't know. We can nearly get there. A couple of medium Ankies will get us there. We just need the money, really. That's why it's really important that we keep an eye on this. I'm going to stay here for a second. I'm not too worried about these episodes being long. This is more a nostalgia trip and chatting and... low key, and hopefully people enjoy that. And if they do, that's great. And if not, who cares? Evolution 2 is out soon. I'll make money then. That's generally for the last couple of months now. That's been my philosophy. It's like, yeah, you know what? I'm gonna have fun with the channel. We'll upload things. If things go well, if things don't go well, it's fine. Evolution 2 is on the way. It'll be fine when Evolution 2 comes out. But yeah, and then that year. I first moved to Manchester is when Jurassic Park Builder came out. And as much as JPOG solidified what I wanted to do, Jurassic Park Builder was when I really started to make money. Wait, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? 6. So that's $1,500. So that means we made more at 250 than we did at 200. So we now up it to 300 and see if we make even more. So if we get 6 again... we make more money. If it's Fumph again, we've drawn even, basically. Velociraptor. I knew they were at the Flaming Cliffs, but that's very exciting still. It's very exciting. You dead. They've just both decided to stop moving entirely. How are you guys doing? Having a little nap? Having a little sniff around? 87%. Ugh, so close to glory. How much is it for the,
Welcome.
I'm just gonna grab it, screw it.
Great.
I don't need money. Money's for nerds. Get that. Give it a little cheeky save. It is holding together. It's been 42 minutes and the game hasn't crashed this time, which is nice. Yeah, Jurassic Park Builder came out and things really took off then. Next few years were really good. I got ahead of myself. We'll talk about that probably in the next video. What I'm going to do is I'm going to try to have a theme to talk about in each video. Today was like the start of the channel, where it all came from, how it all began, and maybe next time will be the pitfalls I fell into, plans for the rest of the channel, regrets, positives, what it's done to my life, blah, 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 blah. I'll have like a little theme in mind. So I'll try to... Anyways. Eins, zwei, we're looking for sex, drei, vier, Fourth? Sex? Sex! So we made $1,800 that time.
Message from Dr. Wu.
And up we go again. Just gotta keep up in it, basically. Do you see what I mean, how slow you make money in this game? Oh, we should go check that dig site, actually. Ah, this is the thing. I kind of want the cash and the potential of getting Ankylosaurus DNA, I suppose. Oh, we're high, though. Kind of getting shafted on my amber. I'll say that much.
Urgent message from John Hammond.
1.5, baby! Oh, right, that's going to throw out my star rating, my ticket system. Tell you what, I'm going to up this to 400. And we'll see what we manage. Because we got the extra half a star, you know, people are loving the park. 43 minutes, a star and a half. That's pretty damn speedy. I'll say that much. What you should do, I mean, you may have seen my race to 5 stars with Beaver on this. This isn't optimal by any stretch. But, you know, it does the job. You spend so much time in JPOG doing nothing. I feel like I need to turn the music up a little bit. The music in this game is absolutely beautiful. And deserves to be heard. I'm just not sure what the sound balance is going to be like.
From Doctor.
It's still quiet, isn't it? I'm going to knock down the ambient. The ambient's the problem.
What should we do?
Message from Dr. Grant.
96%! Okay, cool. If we can find a low, it might push us over the edge. It might just do
Definitely.
It. Let's do it. That might be the one right there. I'm going to pull the dig team out as well. Exhausted. Yeah, we should have been out of there ages ago. That's still good. Sweet. I'm just going to give it a cheeky save. But yeah, so we're nearly there now. When we 100% the Yankee, we'll pop one out and then we'll call it a day. Well, when we can afford it. But yeah, hopefully you guys have enjoyed this. I hope this was a nice, you know, blast from the past. I need umbrellas. Bit of a nostalgia trip. Obviously, we're doing the whole series. Should be done relatively soon, as in I'm not going to, you know, it won't be a week or anything between videos. Just want to play the game and enjoy it, and we can check out weather forecast. Thunderstorm.
Message from Dr. Grant.
Bit of homeless athlete, that's cool. Look at that, all the lights come on the pathway as it starts to rain. Sky gets sort of dark. We might replace the sky textures. There's some really nice ones in the DJE packs. I might swap those out, but I love this music so much, though. So much. I get really nostalgic with this music. It's one thing JPOG has, is that very few games have managed to replicate. Really beautiful original music that really fits into the feel of the films, you know? It still feels quiet to me, I don't know why. I wanted to make a nice, beautiful moment. All you see is my guests crying. I might need another restroom.
Message from Dr. Grant.
I don't know if I'm going to squeeze that in, actually. There. There you go.
Message from Dr. Wu.
Bit of raptor. What did we get, Wu? 100%. There we go, baby. All right, cool. I'm not sure I can afford one. How much does an Anki cost? I'm so close. Wait, how long until the next visitors? Yeah, right now! Sweet! Alright, let's see how much money we get first of all. Eins, zwei, drei, vier, fünf, sechs, sieben, sechs. 6, 12, 18, 20. 2,400 is not bad though. Okay, and we can get ourselves our final dinosaur for the first episode. An Ankylosaurus. Or an Ankylosaurus, if you're that way perturbed. That's definitely not the word. That way inclined. I am definitely not. I'm an Anky guy till the end of days. But you know, people get too hung up on dinosaur pronunciation. I used to be one of those guys. Don't be that person.
What are your instructions?
Oh no, come on, Flaming Cliffs, bring your A game. All average, Flaming Cliffs sucks. I'm going to split them a little bit. It's always more fun to get more fossils, you know, even if they take longer. Doesn't actually make any sense if you think about it, but just don't think about it would be my advice for most things, really.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to announce the arrival of our latest attraction, Ankylosaurus. This shy, reclusive herbivore is guaranteed to delight nature lovers. lovers. Please enjoy.
As if to prove my point, she calls it an ankylosaurus. Isn't she a beauty, though? That skin texture is phenomenal. Funnily enough, this is actually a more realistic ankylosaurus than the Jurassic Park one. You know how it doesn't have the whole body armor kind of thing? It's more sort of part of the body itself, the more round sort of sausage-y shape. That's more realistic. Is she a beaut? She looks stunning. All the pachycephalosaurus is wandering over, super curious what's going on. I do want to get her a friend. She shouldn't have to live here alone.
From Dr. Wu.
But I love her. What are you doing, girl? Are you pooping? You poop on your own time, okay? Please don't be pooping. That was brilliantly well timed. Oh god. That was class, yeah.
Message from Dr. Grant.
Right, well, we're going to end it there, ladies and gentlemen, because I am paranoid about the game crashing, and so I think that's a good way to take it forward. We 100%, and we get every dinosaur for a dig site, and that means it should be a 9-episode series on the dot. We might do some other stuff afterwards, it depends how nostalgic I'm feeling, you know, the missions and exercises and stuff like that. But I really hope you've enjoyed this. Look at the water still going, that's crazy, and the grass. I really hope you've enjoyed this, I really enjoyed it, excited to talk to you about the channel and kind of celebrate the 10th year. I don't remember if I've mentioned this before, so I do have other plans for this 10-year anniversary I'd like to do. I'd like to withdraw my life. I've been talking about that for about 6 years. I've got some other stuff planned. I've got something really big planned, which is in the works for about 2 years now. Genuinely about 2 years, but it's not ready to show yet. That's going to take a few more months. There is stuff happening. It's just... my life is kind of an upheaval at the moment, so things are taking a little bit of time, you know? But we'll get there, and hopefully you guys keep enjoying the content and keep coming around, you know? I want that million. I've got to tell you, one day I want that million subscribers. I know it might take a while. That's okay. I'm okay with that now, you know? I don't need to be the biggest or the best. You know, we're just going to do what we do, and it'll come eventually, and I cannot wait. But until then, here's some nostalgia. Yeah, so thank you so much for joining me. Love you guys. Always have, always will. And I'll see you, you know, we'll be back later this week. Probably Thursday, if I had to guess, for the next episode. So Thursday, Friday, something like that for part 2. Come back then and throw me a like if you enjoyed that video. It really does make me feel like a happy little lemon inside. And quite frankly, who doesn't want to feel like a happy little lemon inside? Precisely. Get to it. And like I say, next video we will talk about the rise and fall. Or the rise, yeah, the rise and fall. Like those next few years in the history of my channel. Cool. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye.